Ready, Matt?
Yup, I am. I just got two more seconds.
I'm coming in here next year with a hacksaw, or not a sawzall.
Huh?
I'm coming in here next year with a sawzall, and I'm gonna go.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's funny, I was thinking the same exact thing last night. I was like, if this thing were about, like, 6 inches lower, it'd be fine.
Well, either that or we're going to have to build some 4x8, 4-inch lifts over here.
Yeah.
Classic case of the construction people not talking to people working in the space.
Well, I think originally they were going to, like, glass this whole thing off.
Yeah, I told them not to do it. Seriously, I
haven't
even done
my
glass. Don't glass it off.
I'm thinking that would not be a good
idea. How am I supposed to hear the show to mix the show
right.
If I'm encased in glass?
Okay, actually,
let me
look for my...
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this evening's presentation of Man of La Mancha. For your safety, exits are located both at the front and rear of the aircraft. We ask that you please turn all pagers and cell phones to the silent mode. There will be a 15-minute intermission, during which refreshments and other goodies will be on sale in the cafeteria. In addition, we are taking t-shirt orders for the t-shirts on display by the ticket table. The cost is $15, and all profits go back into the drama program. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. I'm a scared, it's a bug.
Thank you. accommodations?
No, they appear quite, interesting.
The cells are below. This is the common room for those who wait.
How long do they wait?
Some an hour, some a lifetime.
Do they all await the Inquisition?
No, these are merely thieves, murderers. If you need anything, just shout, if you're able.
What did she mean by that?
Calm yourself. There is a remedy for everything but death.
That could be the very one we need.
Good evening, gentlemen, ladies. I regret being thrust upon you in this manner, and hope you will not find my company objectionable. In any case, I trust I shall not be among you long. The Inquisition...
Enough! I said enough. Noise, trouble, fights. Kill each other if you must. But for God's sake, do it quietly. Who are you? Speak up. Let him go, let him go. Well?
Cervantes. Don Miguel de Cervantes.
A gentleman.
It has never saved me from going to bed hungry.
And what is that?
My servant. May I have the honor?
Well, they call me the governor. What's your game?
My game?
Your specialty man. Cut purse, highwayman.
Oh, nothing so interesting. I am a poet.
Oh, they're putting men in prison for that now, are they?
No, not for that.
Too bad.
Oh, very well. Let's get on with the trial.
Excuse me, but what trial?
Oh, yours, of course.
You don't seem to understand. I'll only be here for
my
a short...
My dear sir, no one enters or leaves this prison without being tried by his fellow prisoners. You understand.
And if I'm found guilty?
Oh, don't worry, you will be.
What sort of a penalty could you possibly...
Oh, what? We usually fine a prisoner all of his belongings?
All of them?
Well, it wouldn't be practical to take more now, would it?
One moment. These things are my livelihood.
I thought you said you were a poet.
Of the theater.
It's false.
Yes, costumes and property. You see, actually, I am a playwright and an actor. So, of course, these poor things could not possibly be of any use to... No, not that, please. Not that.
Heavy. Valuable.
Only to me.
We might let you ransom it.
I don't have any money.
How unfortunate. Paper.
Manuscript.
Still worthless.
Wait! You spoke of a trial. By your own words, I must be given a trial.
Oh, very well. I hereby declare this court in session. All right. Why are you here?
I am to appear before the Inquisition.
Heresy?
Not exactly. We have been employed by the government as tax collectors.
Poet, actor, tax collector.
A temporary thing, to keep us from starvation.
Tell me, how does a tax collector get in trouble with the Inquisition?
I made an assessment against the monastery of La Merced. When they refused to pay, I issued a lien on the property.
You did what?
He foreclosed on a church.
But why are you here?
Someone had to tack the notice to the church door.
These two have empty rooms in their heads.
The law says to treat everyone equally. We only obey the law.
Governor, with your permission, I should like to prosecute this case.
Why?
Let us say I dislike stupidity, especially when it masquerades as virtue. Miguel de Cervantes, I charge you with being an idealist a bad poet, and an honest man. How plead you?
Guilty.
Bravo! It is the judgment of this court.
But, Your Honor, what about my defense?
But you just pleaded guilty.
And since I've admitted guilt, isn't the court required to hear me out?
For what purpose?
Well, the jury may choose to be lenient.
He is trying to gain time.
And do you have a scarcity of that?
Any urgent appointments, anyone?
It is true that I am guilty of these charges. An idealist. I've never had the courage to believe in nothing. A bad poet, that comes a bit more painful.
Let's hear your defense!
Your Honor, if it's all right with you, I should like to present it in the manner that I know best. In the form of a charade.
Charade?
An entertainment, if you will.
Entertainment?
At the very worst, it may beguile your time. And if any of you should care to join...
Governor, I should like to protest.
No. Let's hear him out.
Then, may I set the stage? I shall impersonate a man. Come, enter into my imagination and see him. His name, Alonso Quijano, a country squire, no longer young. He has grown round with age, but his eyes burn with the fire of inner vision. Being retired, he has much time for books. And all he reads oppresses him, fills him with indignation at man's murderous ways towards his fellow man. He broods, and broods, and broods, and finally, from so much brooding, his brains dry up. He lays down the melancholy burden of sanity and conceives the strangest project ever known to man, to become a knight-errant and sally forth into the world to right all wrongs. No longer shall he be plain Alonso Quijano, but a dauntless knight known as Don Quixote de la Mancha! And unbearable world, thou art base and debauched as can be. And a knight with his banners all bravely unfurled, now hurls down his gauntlet to thee. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha, my destiny calls and I go.
Peculiar.
What, my friend?
Well, you see, to me, this great highway to glory looks exactly like the road to El Toboso, where you can buy chickens cheap.
Like beauty, my friend, 'tis all in the eye of the beholder. Only wait, and thou shalt see amazing sights.
What kind?
Why, knights and nations, warlocks, wizards, a cavalcade of vast, unending armies.
They sound dangerous.
They are dangerous, but one there'll be who leads him, Sancho, and he will be most dangerous of all.
Well, who is he? Who?
Great enchanter. Beware him, Sancho, for his thoughts are cold and his spirit shriveled. Where he walks, the earth is blighted, and he has eyes like little machines. But one day we shall meet face to face, Sancho, and on that day...
Well, I wouldn't get too upset, Your Grace. As I always say, have patience and shuffle the cards.
Do you never run out of proverbs?
No, Your Grace. I was born with a belly full of them.
Aha!
What?
How long since we sallied forth?
About 2 minutes.
So soon shall I engage in brave, unequal combat.
Combat? Where?
Canst not thou see? There below.
If Your Grace could just give me a hint.
It is that dark and dreaded ogre by the name of Matagoger. You can tell him by the four great arms a-whirling on his back.
That's a windmill.
Oh, feckless giant standing there! Avast! Avant! On guard! Beware!
Oh, Your Grace! I swear by my wife's little black mustache! That's not a giant! It's only a... Didn't I tell you? Didn't I say? Your Grace, it's only a windmill?
The work of my enemy.
The enchanter!
At the last moment, he transformed that ogre into a windmill. Sancho, it comes to me.
What, Your Grace?
How he was able to upset me. It is because I have never properly been dubbed a knight.
Oh, that's no problem. Just tell me how it's done, and I'll be glad to attend to it.
Thank you, Sancho, but it may only be done by another knight.
That's a problem. I've never seen another knight.
Well, the lord of some castle would do. Or a king. Or even a duke.
Very well, Your Grace. I'll keep my eye out for any kings or dukes as we go. By the way, does Your Grace know where we're going?
Wherever the road may lead.
Oh.
Aha!
What now?
The very place.
Where?
There, a castle.
Castle?
Rockbound amidst the crags.
Crags?
And the banners, all the brave banners flaunting the wind.
Anything on them?
I see a cat. Crouching on a field, tawny, and beneath it the inscription, Meow. Undoubtedly the insignia of some great lord.
Very well, Your Grace. Maybe this is where you can finally get yourself drubbed.
Dubbed. Blow thy bugle that a dwarf may mount the battlements and announce our coming.
I don't see a castle! I do see something. Maybe it's an inn.
An inn.
We'd better go around it, Your Grace. These roadside places can be filled with rough men and women.
No. We shall ride straight to the drawbridge of yon castle, and there thy vision may improve. one thing may seem to be another. To Quixote, a castle. To Sancho, an inn. To someone else, whatever as I may make of it. But for our purposes, let us grant Sancho his vision, an inn. A kindly innkeeper, his less kindly wife. Rough men, muleteers, 15 miles on the road today. And most particular, a woman called Aldonza. Castellano here!
I'm in charge of this place.
We waited, sire. for a dwarf to mount the battlements and announce our coming, but none appeared.
The dwarves are all busy.
Noble lords and ladies, my master, Don Quixote, knight errant, defender of the right and pursuer of lofty undertakings, implores the boon of hospitality.
Well, sir, is it granted?
Of course. Everyone is welcome at this castle.
He's a madman.
Madmen are the children of God. Señor Knight, you must be hungry.
Aye, that I am.
Oh, there's food aplenty for you and your squire, too, if he'll only help me stable your animals. This way.
Gentle knights, fair Shatlan, if there be any among you that require assistance, you need only to speak, and my good right arm is at your service. Whether it be a castle beleaguered by giants, a princess held for ransom, or merely... Dear God, what is she? Sweet lady, fair virgin. I dare not gaze full upon thy countenance, lest I be blinded by beauty. But I implore thee, speak once thy name.
Ardonza.
My lady jests.
Ardonza.
The name of the kitchen scullion, or mayhap my lady's serving maid.
I told you my name, now get out of the way.
Did my lady think to put me to the test? Oh, sweet sovereign of my captive heart, I shall not fail thee, for I know. I have dreamed thee too long, never seen thee or touched thee, but known thee with all of my heart. Half a prayer, half a song, thou hast always been with me, though we have been always apart. Phantom to fade in the air. Dulcinea, Dulcinea, I have sought thee, sung thee, dreamed thee, Dulcinea. Now I've found thee, and the world shall know thy glory. Dulcinea.
Thank you.
propose to offer a defense.
But this is my defense.
The most peculiar I've ever seen.
But as long as it entertains.
I believe the word is diverts. Your purpose is to divert us from ours.
Precisely. And now if I may get on with it.
Continue your defense.
Imagine now the family that our brave knight left behind. Not the noble lords and ladies and retainers of Don Quixote de la Mancha, but the simple womenfolk of a country squire known as Alonso Quijana. Imagine their shock as news of the master's madness reaches them. To his niece, Antonia, who is worried about its effect on her forthcoming marriage. To his housekeeper of many years, who is worried about even darker matters. To the local madre, who has known Alonso all of her life. And shortly they will enter a character whose philosophy, I think, will appeal enormously to you. Alonso's niece and his housekeeper hurry to the local neighborhood church. Sancho, may we have a church? Anguished by this terrible situation, and not unaware of what the neighbors may think, they seek help and advice from the local imam. The local hermano? But no matter what she may do or say, you may be sure she is only thinking of him.
Oh.
man of breeding, intelligence, logic. He is Sanson Carrasco, graduate of the University of Salamanca. A man who carries his own self-importance as though afraid of breaking it.
We must do something.
There he is.
Thank you. I had forgotten how quickly family quarrels could get out of hand. With so much at stake in the game, let us rearrange the pieces. The queen, clever. The castle, formidable. The bishop, charmingly diagonal. And now, the problem of the knight.
Sanson, have you heard?
On my way here, I was informed by at least 10 people. My dear, your uncle is the laughingstock of the entire neighborhood. Hermana, what do you know of this?
Only that the good Señor Quijana has been carried away by his imagination.
No, Señor Quijana has lost his mind and is suffering from delusions.
Is there a difference?
Exactly to the rule. I beg to remind you, Hermana, that I am a doctor.
Please don't argue. We must do something about him.
To be quite honest, my dear, I'm a little more concerned about us.
What do you mean, us?
Our marriage, my dear. You see, there is a certain embarrassment in having a madman in the family. In the eyes of others...
Oh, come, doctor.
I do not relish claiming a lunatic for uncle.
Well, the innocent must pay for the sins of the guilty. Guilty of what? A gentle delusion?
How do you know it is gentle? By this time, who knows what violence he may have caused? He was armed
with a sword and a knife.
Sanson, I had hoped so much for us. For you, really. Everything was to be for you. My uncle's house, land...
True, doctor. In time, everything would be yours. After all, if one is to serve science, one must have the means.
Are you a woman of God or a pawnbroker?
What I meant was, consider the challenge.
Challenge?
Think of what cleverness it would take to wean this man from his imagination, to turn him from his journey and persuade him to return home.
Yes, that is a challenge.
Impossible.
He can't have gotten far.
No more than a day's journey.
Get ready, Hermana. We shall go after him.
But as we go, there is one thing that I want the world to know.
I fear with pain that once again we now will hear a very often heard refrain.
Well, let's see it.
me so I could commit it to practice.
What made him think I couldn't read?
Well, as he explained it, noble ladies are always spending all their time with their needlework.
Needlework?
You know, embroidering banners for their knights.
Uh-huh.
They have no time for studies.
Well, what's it say?
Most lovely sovereign and high-born lady. The heart of this thy vassal knight faints for thy favor.
That's good.
Oh, fairest of the fair, purest of the pure, incomparable Dulcinea.
That again, my name is Aldonza.
But my master calls you Dulcinea.
Why?
I don't know. But I can tell you from experience that knights have their own language for everything. And it's best not to ask questions, because it only gets you into trouble. I beg thee grant that I may kiss the nethermost hem of thy garment.
Kiss my witch?
If you keep interrupting, the whole thing will be gone out of my head.
Well, what does he want?
I'm telling you. Nethermost hem of thy garment. And send to me a token of thy fair esteem, that I may carry as my standard into battle.
What kind of token?
He says generally it's a silken scarf.
Your master's a crack brain.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Well, they say one madman makes 100 and love makes 1,000.
What is that?
I'm not sure.
Well, what are you waiting for?
A token.
I'll give him a token. Here.
But, my lady...
Don't you my lady me, or I'll crack you like an egg. Wait a minute. Whoa, wait a minute. Come here. Sit down. Why do you follow him?
Oh, that's easy to explain. Why? I'm telling you. It's because.
Because why?
I like him. I really like him. Tear out my fingernails one by one. I like him. I don't have a very good reason. Since I've been with him, cuckoo nuts have been in season. Yet there's nothing I can do. Chop me up. Still I'll get the sky, though I can't tell you why that I like him.
That doesn't make any sense!
Well, that's because you're not a squire.
Alright, I'm not a squire. How's a squire?
Well, I ride behind him, and then he fights. Then I pick him up off the ground.
What do you get out of it? want what the other one's got. Still not good enough. That's the same as I get, maybe better. Fine hair, just as crazy as your master. Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. You do as you're told. But who can figure him out? Why does he do the things he does? Why does he do these things? Why does he march through that tree that he's in, covered in glory and rusty old tin? Why does he live in a world that can be? And what does he want of me? What does he want of me? Why does he say the says, why does he say these things? Sweet Dulcinea and missive and such, never most hem of thy garment I touch. No one can be what he wants me to be. Oh, what does he want of me? What does he want of me?
Moverly suffer again, and highborn lady.
It's a love letter.
It's a stupid joke.
Well, then why so hot about it?
Has he touched your heart?
Nobody touches my heart.
All those fine words.
Fine words. He's a man, isn't he? Wants what every other man wants.
Aldonza.
Later, when I'm finished in the kitchen.
In that case, leave it all to me.
He may not even recognize us.
I am prepared for that contingency. Should he fail to recognize us, I will proceed with a...
Who is it crying help of Don Quixote de la Mancha? Is there an army of giants on the march? A king under enchantment? Or maybe... Why, my friends.
You know us?
Should a man not know his friends, Dr. Carrasco? Madre Perez!
Oh, Maria Alonso!
I should prefer that you address me properly. I am Don Quixote, knight-errant of La Mancha.
Señor Quijana.
Don Quixote.
There are no giants, no knights, no kings under enchantment. There have been no knights for 300 years.
So learned, yet so misinformed.
These are facts.
Facts are the enemy of truth.
Your Grace?
Ah, most fortunate of squires. Did she receive thee? And the token? What of the token? Gossip. Forgive me. I am overcome.
It's from his lady.
Aha, I see. So there's a woman involved, is there?
A lady? The Lady Dulcinea. Her beauty is beyond compare. Her quality, perfection. She is the very meaning of woman, and all meaning woman has to man.
To each his Dulcinea. Oh, I have
Sancho, someone approaches.
And I go my merry way.
Barber? I ply my trade from village to village.
made the mistake. Go.
Silence! Know thou what this really is? The golden helmet of Mambrino. When worn by one of the noble heart, it renders him invulnerable to all wounds. Misbegotten knave, where didst thou steal it?
I didn't steal it!
Hand it over.
But it cost me half a crown!
Hand it over, or I shall... I must say, your grace, it is worth half a crown.
Thank you. Not necessarily. We know the sickness. Now to find the cure.
The cure. It be not worse than the disease.
Of each true knight, his duty,
nay, his privilege.
Oh!
What's all this noise? Oh, a terrible thing.
What glorious thing?
Sir Castellano, I beg to inform you that the right has triumphed.
Your grace, are you hurt?
Oh, no, Sancho. It is a little weakness, temporary and of no...
Oh, he is hurt. What's happening? What's going on?
The madman. I knew it.
Hurry, Maria. That's some bandages.
Oh, poor warrior. Poor lunatic. I warned you what would happen if we put the madman in our
house. Go to bed, Maria. Go to bed.
I warned you.
Go to bed.
Oh. He's coming around.
Oh. Might I always wake to such a vision?
Well, your grace, we certainly did a job out here.
Yes, we routed them, didn't we?
That bunch will be walking bow-legged for a week.
My lady, it is not seemly to gloat over the fallen.
Let them rot in hell.
Sir Knight, I'm a tame and peaceful man. I don't mean to be inhospitable, but I must ask you to leave as soon as you're able.
I am sorry to have offended the dignity of thy castle, and I shall depart as soon as day dawns. But before I leave, I must ask that you fulfill thy promise.
Promise?
True. It is not yet daybreak, but I have maintained my vigil, and I have proven myself in combat. Therefore, I beg that you dub me knight.
Very well. Let's get this over with.
Sancho.
Yes, Your Grace?
Wilt thou be good enough to fetch my sword?
Yes.
My lady, I cannot tell you how glad I am that you should be here to witness this solemn moment that seals my vocation.
Are you ready?
I am.
Very well then, kneel.
Don Quixote de la Mancha, I hereby dub thee knight.
Your lordship?
What's the matter? Didn't I do it right?
Well, if your lordship could make some mention of the deeds that I performed to gain this honor.
All right.
Don Quixote de la Mancha, having proved yourself this day in glorious and terrible combat, and by my authority as lord of this castle, I hereby dub thee knight.
Oh, your lordship!
Something else?
Well, it is customary for the lord to grant his knight an added name. If your lordship could grant such a name to me.
Hail, knight of the woeful countenance, knight of the woeful countenance. Wherever you go, people will know of the glorious deeds of the knight of the woeful countenance. Farewell and good cheer, oh my brave cavalier, ride onward to glorious stride. I swear when you're gone, I'll remember you well for all of the rest of my life. Hail, knight of the woeful countenance, knight of the woeful countenance. Wherever you go, face to the foe, they will quail at the sight of the knight of the woeful countenance. Oh, valorous knight, go and fight for the right, and battle all villains at me. But oh, when you do, what will happen to you? Thank God I won't be there to see.
Oh,
Senor Knight of the Woeful Countenance. I'm going to bed. I advise that you do the same.
Knight of the Woeful Countenance.
It's a beautiful name.
Come, Your Grace. Let's get you to bed.
Not yet, my friend. I still owe something to my enemies.
Oh, that account's been paid.
Oh, no, my lady. I must raise them up and minister to their wounds.
What?
Yes, nobility demands.
It does?
Yes. Therefore, I shall take these.
I'll take them. I'll minister.
But, my lady...
They were my enemies, too.
Oh. Blessed one! Blessed one!
Come, Your Grace.
Blessed one! Blessed one! Life, this do I swear.
That sound? The men of the Inquisition.
What does it mean?
So haul someone off and put the question to him. Next thing he knows, he's burning.
Are they coming for me?
Very possibly. Are you afraid, Cervantes? Where's your courage? Is that in your imagination, too? No escape, Cervantes. This is happening. Not to your brave man of La Mancha, but to you. Quick, Cervantes. Call upon him. Let him save you. Let him shield you if he can from that.
Trap of thy peasant mind. Pokemon. Brother and sister, yes!
Can't you two just declare a truce?
And allow Wicked
I'm afraid wickedness wears a very thick armor, my friend.
And for that, wouldst thou have me stop trying? Nay, let a man be stricken down 10,000 times, still must he rise and again do battle. The enchanter may confuse the outcome, but the effort remains sublime.
Lies! Madness! Lies!
Alfonso, what happened?
Ask him.
Maria! Maria, get some bandages! Hurry!
I shall punish them that did this crime.
Crime. You know the worst crime of all? Being born. For that you get punished your whole life.
My lady.
I am not your lady. I am not any kind of a lady. I was spawned in a ditch by a mother who left me there naked and cold and too hungry to cry. I never begged her, I'm sure she left hoping that I'd have the good sense to die. And of course there's my father, I'm told that young ladies can point to their fathers with me.
Foolish pretender. Thy pretense is a child's mockery.
and thy dreams are dust beneath my feet.
Oh, false knight, discourteous! Before I chastise thee, tell me thy name.
Thou shalt hear it in due course.
Then say why thou seekest me out.
Thou called upon me, Don Quixote. Thou reviled me and threatened.
The enchanter, behold at thy feet the gauge of battle.
Oh, your grace!
What terms do we fight?
Choose thine own.
Very well. If thou art defeated, thy freedom is forfeit, and thou must obey my every command. And thy conditions?
If thou art still alive, thou shalt kneel and beg mercy of my lady Dulcinea.
And where shall I find this lady?
There she stands.
Ha! Thy lady is an alley cat.
Monster! Defend thyself!
Hold! Thou hast my name, Don Quixote. Now I shall tell it. I am called the Knight of the Mirrors.
Then prepare thyself. False knight! Ha! Ah! Ah! What trickery is this? Ha! Ah!
Ah!
Quixote, what dost thou see? A gallant knight? Naught but an aging fool!
No! What are you doing?
Look, Don Quixote, dost thou see him? A madman dressed for a masquerade! Look, Don Quixote, see him as he truly is. See the clown. Drown, Don Quixote. Drown in the mirror. Go deep, deep. The masquerade is ended. Confess, thy lady is a trollop on thy dream, the nightmare of a disordered mind.
No. No. I am Don Quixote, knight errant of La Mancha.
Yes.
And my lady is the Lady Dulcinea. I am Don Quixote, knight errant of La Mancha, and my lady, no.
It is done.
Your grace, it's only Dr. Carrasco. Look, it's only Sansón Carrasco.
Forgive me, Señor Quijano, it was the only way.
Thank you.
younger. Dark cavern of the mind.
According to recent theory...
Doctor, please.
Don't you think I did right?
Yes, there is the contradiction of one thing.
You again.
Tell him to go away, please.
What harm can he do?
Yes. It's already been done.
Armana! Could I talk to him? Then I won't say much.
And no mention of knight errantry.
Of course not. Does one speak of the rope in the house of the hanged? Oh, excuse me, Your Grace.
Grace.
Just a few words to my tongue. Don't ask. Don't chat. Don't add the thought of this and that. I'll tell him all the troubles I have had. And since he doesn't hear, at least he won't feel bad. When I first got home, my wife Teresa beat me. But the blows fell very lightly on my back. She kept missing every other stroke and crying from the heart that while I was gone, she got and lost the neck. Of course, I hit her back in grace, but she's a lot harder than I am. And, well, you know what they say. Whether the stone hits the pitcher, or the pitcher hits the stone, it's going to be bad for the pitcher. So I've got bruises from here to...
closer, girl. Now,
call me Lord. I am not a lord.
You are my lord, Don Quixote.
Don Quixote. Forgive me. I have been ill and am confused by shadows. It is possible that I knew you once, but I do not remember.
This way.
Please, please try to remember.
Is it so important?
Everything. My whole life. You spoke to me and everything was different.
I spoke to you?
And you called me by another name. Dulcinea. Dulcinea. Once you found a girl and called her Dulcinea. When you spoke the name, an angel seemed to whisper, Dulcinea, Dulcinea.
Now call me to ride. Yes, the trumpets are calling.